fuck people, fuck.
I hate people so much.
I just hate people.
Now entering Nerdist.com.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this edition of the Half Hour Happy Hour with Allison and Alex. I'm Alex Albrecht.
I'm Allison Hayslip, and for about the next 30 minutes, we are going to drink a little booze and spit a little news. I'll never stop laughing when you say edition, like we're a newspaper.
Printed this week, physically, and handed to you directly. This week's edition of the Half Hour Happy Hour. Sitting in with us is the man of Oot the Hour, which
Oot?
I don't know what that means.
Like
I think it means like out of the hour, but
whatever.
Okay. It's Tom, Oot Super Volcano Krajewski. Hey. How you doing there, Tom?
How are you guys doing?
Doing good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool.
What happened this week? What's going on?
Well,
You don't ask this next question, Tom.
Yeah.
But we can talk about you guys.
Since when did you become Segway guy, Tom?
I think that if I ask you a question, you'd be happy to talk about yourself. So I'm helping you out.
I mean,
Tom,
always.
Segway Krajewski.
Oh, my gosh.
That's what they say. That man does not walk. He only rides a Segway.
Only Segways.
Well, it's funny.
What's funny?
It's not funny. It's merely not even interesting.
Oh, why are we talking about it?
I got my computer upgraded.
Yay!
We got a lot of
response. We're on a fancy computer?
We're on a fancy operating system on the same old computer.
Got it.
But now I don't have to worry about that weird esoteric feature loop.
Esoteric? I don't think that's the word.
Anyway.
That's not the right adjective.
I'm very tired. We got a lot of emails.
Oh, good.
And I got a couple tweets.
Nice.
And somebody tweeted me, and I should have looked up who it was that actually tweeted me.
So we could thank them.
Tweeter. Please make this
and
go
they,
tweet.
They gave you a fix?
They gave me a fix, which... As it's one of those ones where as I was sort of doing it, I was like, I feel like I should have been able to figure this out myself.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's one of those where I was like, God damn it. Stuart Jones.
Thank you,
God
Stuart
damn
Jones.
It, Stuart Jones. I mean, thank you, Stuart Jones. So what Stuart Jones, we got a lot of emails and all this stuff, but this is the one that I was like, I'm just going to try that because that seems really easy. So there was a lot of the issue with the two-factor authentication.
Right.
And so a lot of people were like, well, just turn off two-factor authentication. Then you can log in. Then you can turn it back on.
Yeah.
And I was just like, that's a lot of mishigas for something I don't really give a shit about. Computer works. Yeah. And then
I have to do that every time I get a new phone.
Yeah.
Turn it off because you can't. Yeah.
So then Stuart Jones was like,
Stujo.
The weirdest, this is one of those things where I was like, that does not make any fucking sense. My brain would never have me go, I'm just going to try this.
Yeah.
Which is, you type in your password.
Right.
You hit sign in and it goes, no, wrong password.
Yeah.
And then your phone's like, hey, somebody's trying to log in. You want to allow it? Yes. Here's a code.
Right.
Okay. You then put your password in, followed by the code.
Oh.
I would never do that. And by the way, just even saying it like that, it doesn't even make sense because it's like, I assume that there's going to be a prompt for me. If it says, put in your password followed by the code,
right?
I immediately assume I put in my password, then I am prompted to put in a code.
Yeah, exactly.
And but that was the loop I was in. But it turns out, no, what Apple wants you to do is literally write your password in your password field and then add these six numbers.
Yeah, that's so weird.
I would never feel
like that's two different.
Yeah, like my password is my password. It's sacrosanct.
Yeah, yeah.
Like that's in a vault.
Yeah, that's
you
in a
can't
vault.
Add anything to my
that's
password.
That's locked
without,
into your in, your yes, dial my, switch
exactly.
card holder, business card holder.
Yeah, maybe it has a belt loop so you can have it
gosh.
On your belt.
No.
I'm just saying, you can do a lot of things with this. Great, it's a great product. Great product. I'm fully behind it.
Right.
Anyway, so I was like, A, that can't work.
Yeah.
B, very easy to test, and I don't have to like fuck with anything.
Yeah,
because that's the other thing is I didn't want to fuck with anything because this is half hour happy hours
this
right
computer,
here.
Right.
So I was like, if this explodes,
not the three of us. Screw the three of us. It's all that machine right there.
If this explodes, we can't do anything.
I know.
There's nowhere for us to go to repair.
Wow.
So I was like, well, I could at least put that in. Sure enough, put it in. Boop, done.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah. Okay. Welcome to the show. And I was like, great, upgrade to the operating system. Boop. Now whenever I go to the App Store, it does the same thing. I like log in and this
buzzes.
Thing goes brr, and I say accept and it says put in the password and then a code prompt pops up. So
yeah.
Now I just put the code
in.
Oh,
so
boom,
now
boom,
a
boom,
code
boom.
Prompt.
Now it works.
Oh, because
the operating
system
was old and didn't have that code prompt system.
Oh.
So now I'm fully operational.
Wow.
All right, good for us. Mm. Glad I figured that out.
That's no boom.
All Tom. Thank you, Tom. You're
Thank welcome. You, Stuart Jones.
Yeah, and it's really funny how like little things like that make you happy.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that's not...
Yeah.
That shouldn't make me happy in life.
It kind of does. It's like when your cable goes out, and then you don't have it for a day, and you're, like, completely miserable.
Yeah.
And then the cable back, and you don't turn it on, but you're happy to have it back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Just, like, you can't live without it.
Yeah.
Something stupid.
Speaking of which...
Ooh.
I guess the Tesla Powerwall hasn't really been fully operational until now.
There's a lot of fully operational stuff. There's a lot of Death Star references.
First off, it's happening. We got LADWP finally agreed to come and bring the net meter. It's not here yet.
Oh.
Anytime between now and 6 weeks from now.
Oh, God.
But once that happens, everything is done.
Yeah.
But the guy came and like finalized the Tesla Powerwall, and how fun is this? The like, see if it's working on the Tesla Powerwall.
Right.
Is he walks over to our main cutoff from the grid and he goes, ka-chonk.
Oh.
And my phone goes, whoop, backup. We're in backup now.
Oh.
And you walk inside and the TV's on.
Oh, that's cool.
The lights are on. And I was like, well, hello. And
officially went off the grid.
Officially. And then he puts it back on because I don't have enough power walls to charge to be off that long.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it's like,
if, and then.
I don't know if you guys know this. It's been fucking hot as shit.
Yeah, no, it's been so hot.
We actually have a story I'm going to talk about with how hot the world is.
We didn't talk about it a lot too much last week.
Well, we did, but that was just our current location.
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't just the fact that the world is hot now.
Okay.
But my buddy was like, yeah, you know, we're going to get, like, I got the thing in the mail that was like, get ready for rolling brownouts all throughout the summer.
I didn't get that yet.
Yeah.
I didn't get it,
Alex,
but my buddy
I'm
did.
I'm definitely coming over because I only have one air conditioning unit in my place.
Oh,
here's
really?
The problem.
Oh, no.
One of the only things that's not on the power wall is the
air conditioning. Why?
It's too much of a spike. It's because it's higher than 30 amps.
Oh, wow. Man.
And so it's not on the thing. However, I believe the solar panels can still power that. So it may Weird. Still work during the solar days.
Like solar days?
Yeah, like
days with the sun.
The days with the sun.
Yeah.
But if we have a power outage and also the sun is eaten by a sky monster.
I hate those sky
then
monsters.
Then maybe the AC is not going to work.
They're assholes.
Yeah. I mean, look, they're hungry. They eat suns. Yeah.
Fucking
I get
asshole
it.
Sky monsters.
It's NASA's job to stop them.
It is.
Right? Yeah.
That's literally all they do.
Yeah.
We think that they're out there looking for stuff, but really they got their eyes on one sky monster, and whenever it gets too close to the sun, they shoot lasers at it. And back it up.
And pew,
back
pew.
It up.
But that would be amazing if that's what if that's what NASA did.
That would
did.
Be awesome.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Drop it in the ocean like Bin Laden.
Yeah.
What? Oh my gosh. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Sometimes I miss because I'm on the other side of the table from Tom. I sometimes miss
Tom throws
little
him in
like
there.
Underneath.
Yeah. You gotta
things.
Keep you gotta be on your toes with Tom
also,
around.
Also, Tom doesn't like talking into the mic half the time.
I do.
So.
Don't I talk into the mic now?
You do now.
You do
when
now.
When we first started, you were very much
like,
not
because Allison always told me that it was her show and shut up.
It's my show.
Don't talk.
My name is first, damn it. Finally.
My name is in the title, not yours. I get it.
Allison just reaches
I'm
over
back.
And slowly moves Tom's microphone down to zero. And Tom's like, I was talking for like 5 minutes in that show and I can't hear any of it.
Thank God.
Like, what happened? I don't know.
I love the like fake rivalry we've created.
That's amazing.
Fake?
It's fake.
Oh, I mean,
fake.
Totally real.
Lego
real.
My egos.
I guess I do yell at you via text message a lot.
What else? Yeah. What else has been going on this week?
I think we need to segue into the
what?
Email about
the heat.
Which
heat?
What?
Heat. The heat.
There wasn't a heat email. I was just going to read a story about the heat, which I can do now.
Yeah, we were on that subject.
Let's talk heat.
Yeah.
Okay,
you ready for this?
I feel like weird going back to it.
I get it.
Yeah.
Phoenix flights canceled because it's too hot for planes to fly.
Yeah.
How
I
so?
Saw that.
What
the
it
hotter
stop?
It gets,
the less lift?
The thinner the
know.
Air.
Yeah.
Oh.
And if the air is too thin, you cannot generate
lift. So the molecules
lift.
Are moving too quickly.
Yeah.
They're not like.
There you go. Science.
Yeah. Science.
That's the light science for the evening.
Science, science, science.
How hot was it then exactly?
Let me see if it says.
That was the thing.
120 degrees.
120.
But that doesn't seem.
That's how
that.
I was. Yeah, it says in Palm Springs it's like 120 degrees.
I know it's hot as shit, but I mean, it doesn't seem excessively hot. Mm. For Phoenix, you know?
No, I get that. Well, no, but it has a maximum operating temperature of 118 degrees.
Oh, wow. So just those 2 degrees.
2 degrees.
Wow.
Because, and so here's the deal. This is what happened. The air gets so thin that it can't generate enough lift. Here's the thing. You can generate enough lift if you have enough velocity, but the velocity needed increases so much that the runway is not long enough for the planes to take off. And you really only need to lose a couple feet because there's probably a giant barrier of like 100 feet before of safety.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Of like, we're way going to make it because it's, you know, commercial aviation.
Right.
But here's the thing. They were like, okay, we have two choices. We either double the flights, meaning if you take half the passengers off, you can get enough lift to be able to make it.
Yeah.
But they would be losing so much money that they were like, it's better to just cancel all the flights.
Wow.
So the whole day, all the flights. Now, flights in.
Yeah. Could land.
Could land because landing doesn't take as much.
Right.
It's not. The issue was the escape velocity.
Yeah. Man, I'd be like, don't take me to Phoenix. Land somewhere else. I don't want to be stuck in Phoenix.
I got the fix. You use a giant slingshot. You slingshot the plane up into the air.
They do it on aircraft.
I know. Yep.
That's literally what they do on aircraft.
They stole that idea from me.
Yeah. They were like, you know what? There's this young baby named Tom.
You mean on aircraft carriers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did I just say aircraft?
You just said aircraft.
I know what you meant.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was trying to figure it out. Like, I was aircraft. What do you mean they do that on aircrafts? Yeah.
All the aircrafts are built in with their own personal slingshots. You guys didn't know this?
Yeah.
You guys, I'm a pilot.
Oh, that's right.
You were.
I'm a light pilot.
You're a pilot light. Pilot. A pilot light.
I'm a pilot light. That's exactly what I am. Shit.
That's good. Oh my gosh. I walked past this store last night with my friend, and it was like this like kitschy little store. And I was like, oh, that place is called Antiques. And I was like, oh my God. Oh, like, it wasn't until I said it out loud. I was like, Antiques.
Oh, that is amazing.
And then I just laughed at myself for 5 minutes. And my friend was like, you're so weird. And I'm like, I didn't get it. I didn't get it until I read it.
So I had this very interesting, just saying velocity, escape velocity, all that stuff made it very interesting to me.
Made you feel smart.
When I was in the mountains with my dad.
Yeah.
I don't know how we got on the topic of orbits, but he
your
was
dad
like,
is, he,
I know because
runs
my dad
space.
Is space, but he was like, I really like telling people, like, you know, explaining to people about orbits because a lot of people don't understand really how it works, that it's not about height, it's about velocity. And I was like, what? And he was like, He was like, so you know that if you are standing with a ball in your hand and you let go, it falls to the ground.
Yes. Yeah.
And it falls very fast. Yeah. And it goes, boom. That's gravity, right? If you throw the ball, because it's traveling away from you faster, it still falls to the ground, but it just falls to the ground
further
away.
Right.
And if you shoot a bullet out of a gun, it's going way faster than that.
Right.
And it'll start to fall, but it'll fall way away.
Yeah.
Well, if you can shoot a bullet fast enough that the drop of the bullet equals the curve of the earth, so that as the bullet is dropping, the earth is also dropping from underneath it, it will stay in perpetual orbit around the earth.
Let's try it.
Yeah, so he was like, that's how satellites stay in orbit. Yeah. It's not just they pick a number and they stay up there. It's that they actually are traveling around the earth they're falling at the rate that the earth spins. Yeah.
Wow. Don't they always fall then? Like, they always fall into the ocean. Satellites.
Well,
I forget how it works.
So most of them are, if you get it into a geosynchronous orbit.
that was science.
I know
right
a couple,
there.
I know a couple things about things. So if you keep the velocity going with engines. The other thing up in space is there's no drag coefficient. So there's no, because it's a vacuum. So once it's going, it's going.
Yeah.
So what happens is, That's how they sort of like destroy satellites if they want to like decommission a satellite, is they basically just knock it down. They like
with their
tap
own,
it.
With their own
yeah, they just let the engine go boop, boop, and then it'll degrade.
Right.
And then it'll burn up in the atmosphere and then the
and it hits a major city.
Hits a major city.
Did I already talk about on the show? I feel like I might have, but did I talk about how I was baffled by the story of how we actually discovered Neptune?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, okay. So this is back in like.
So continue this science story.
Science.
And by Neptune, you mean the sea god,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
I was always baffled as how we discovered
also
Neptune
known
the
as
sea god.
Aquaman, Jason Momoa.
totally.
No. So this is back in like the 1600s or the 1700s when they just had telescopes and they were looking at the sky. And at this point, the only planets that had been discovered were up through Uranus or Uranus. Wait, is Uranus before? No. What's before Neptune? Mercury,
I don't know.
Venus,
any.
Earth, Mars.
Wait, you know geosynchronous orbit,
Jupiter?
But you don't know the planets in our. No.
Does it go Jupiter?
I don't memorize.
And then Neptune?
Stuff.
Yes, I
there
think that's
There's a thing,
it.
Right? Like, Mommy makes jam yeah. on Tuesday nights with Bill.
What?
Right?
There's no planet.
There's a thing.
There's a thing.
I forget what it is.
That's where you get Terranus.
From Saved by the Bell, it's Vemenschnup.
Vemenschnup. So yeah. Do the thing. Vemenschnup.
Oh, it's got to be Mvenschnup. Because Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter.
Mm-hmm.
So that after, okay, so at this point, we knew through Jupiter. We had
got
to,
it.
We knew all the planets existed through Jupiter. That's
got
it.
Got it.
But.
And there they were.
Yeah.
A young Alison Hoslip.
Hoslip?
In Germany. Yeah, it's
old times.
Oh,
I'm in Germany.
Hoslip. Old times. looking at her telescope.
But
so it has to be another planet.
So they discovered Jupiter.
Sounds just like it.
But Jupiter wasn't. They were like, oh, this Jupiter's the furthest planet,
yeah.
right? But Jupiter's orbit wasn't exactly what it should have been based on what they had discovered already.
Mm-hmm.
So
it was like wobbling.
Yeah, it was like just always like a few degrees off or whatever it was, and so. You know, the scientists all got together.
Dr. Alison Hoslip?
Yeah. And they determined that the only way Jupiter would have that orbit is if there was another planet in this exact location working at its orbit.
Oh.
Wait a minute. You know what I'm realizing? I think maybe this was Neptune and Uranus. I think that's it. I think it's Neptune that wasn't having the
crew. It's always difficult to find Uranus.
Exactly.
Usually you just have to believe it exists.
And then they realized the only reason, the only way that it could have that orbit is if there was a planet. And so they just kept pointing telescopes to that part of the sky.
Until they were
and
like
good
enough.
And they ended up being off like by a slight amount, but then they eventually found the planet. But so they basically like mapped the sky and they were like, there's gonna be a planet there, we just haven't seen it yet, and then they figured it out.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's fucking crazy.
I know. Isn't that insane?
I would love to take I would hate this, but it would be interesting to take a course on like astrophysics.
Right.
To like you like see the boards with like all the shit on it and you're like, that's not a thing. You know what I mean?
What boards? Yeah, what boards with
like,
all what
like
shit?
In the, like, you know, like a beautiful
you're talking
mind
in the
boards.
Movies? Okay, yes. And
yeah. But those things are real things. Like
the equations.
The equations.
That's what you're
like,
trying to say.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
That's all fake. You know what I mean?
Well,
but I would love somebody to like walk me through like this is that and this is that. And then that is this because of this and that. And I'm like, I don't, I'm never going to do it, but just to follow along and be like, oh, okay.
My brother was an astrophysics major in college.
I feel like there needs to be a Skype conversation.
Yeah,
with
maybe
some chalkboards.
Yeah,
let's find out about.
Oh my gosh! You know what my brother
like
told me?
Big chalkboard.
When I was when I was at his home for Memorial Day weekend.
Back to my, his residential.
Have you guys heard about the upcoming banana apocalypse?
No.
Oh my gosh.
No, but I feel like why do we not know of an impending banana pike?
So here's the deal.
Banana peel we're going to
bananas like original bananas, like how God created bananas, are actually not all that appetizing or appealing to us. They're not that like yellow color that we're used to.
Oh, so they're more like a plantain.
Covered in feathers.
Kind of, they're covered.
Shut up.
Feathers, amazing. And they're just not as sweet. And so the banana that, you know how like the banana flavored candies are much sweeter than, well, but they don't really taste like bananas today.
Yeah.
Correct.
That's what bananas used to taste like.
Oh.
So they had, farmers had basic, not genetically engineered, but crossbred bananas.
That is genetically engineered, but yes, that is exactly what that is.
Okay. Well, they did that.
That's why people are like,
well, I'm saying farmers did it, not geneticists.
Right.
Yeah. So they crossbred bananas until it became the
yellow,
sweet banana
yes.
that people, like our parents used to eat, right? And then in like the 60s or the 70s or something like that, there was a banana epidemic. Because basically, since they made all these bananas,
yeah,
they're technically all clones of each other. They're all clones because they don't grow naturally.
So they got
right?
banana cancer or they something?
A virus or a bacteria or something like wiped out, because if they're all the same thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Then they don't have that protection. It's like purebred dogs.
Exactly.
Like,
it's like purebred dogs.
Hips.
So all of these bananas get wiped out, and there were smaller factories that had this other version of the
and
banana.
And they're like, quick, use the shitty one from 2 weeks ago.
Basically. All right. And so that became the new banana, and that's the banana that we eat today.
So we eat shitty offspring
of
eat the touched brother.
Yeah, the touched brother.
You're just sort of like, tasty, you know what?
Yeah,
he's
not,
pretty, but
it's not
that
sweet,
guy's dumb as
but
rocks.
But here's the thing.
It's
the
not
banana.
As sweet. He's more of an asshole than the other banana. Okay. He's not as sweet.
Right. Exactly. But the banana that we eat today, again, they're all clones of each other, and there's a bacteria or something that's happening.
There's a second culling of the banana.
There's an upcoming banana apocalypse if
so,
we can't stop it.
We're gonna get a new banana then?
No, but it would be a worse
one?
Banana.
Huh?
It would be a worse banana.
It might explain why I never really liked bananas. If they didn't taste like our parents when they were a kid. This is kind of
didn't taste like our parents?
Like you said, our parents had different tasting bananas.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But bananas. I never understood the banana split. Why would I want ice cream with a?
Because it makes it taste delicious.
Yeah, but then why put the banana?
The only way bananas taste delicious is if you throw sugar, rum, and cinnamon on top of them and light them on fire.
This is true.
And basically, they become
just
not even.
Sugar.
I like banana chips. Like when you get them in trail mix, I like them.
Yeah, in trail mix, they're okay.
Yeah.
On their own, disgusting.
Yeah.
Like a bag of potato.
So you're not concerned about the upcoming banana apocalypse?
It will not change my eating habits in one iota.
Got it.
Not even close.
Nope.
I mean, maybe smoothie? I don't even do smoothies.
Smoothies actually with them. No, they're good
smoothies is good with them. But then again, a shittier version of it might be fine.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't. I'm not going to lose any sleep over it.
Yeah. Daryl, the asshole cousin of who's not as sweet. She's like, fuck you guys. Oh, man. This guy's not sweet, but it is a banana.
It's a banana.
I look forward to find out what the color is of this new banana.
Well, I think they're going to stick with...
They should change it up. I think they're going to stick with yellow. Yeah.
They're going to shoot with purple.
Yeah.
Just think how weird it would be if you had like a purple banana and then you peeled it and it was like dark purple inside.
That'd be awesome.
Fuck.
Hey, we already have like crosses between like what, peaches and like plums or those plums and oranges.
Oh, we cross
the outs or whatever.
Yeah. What's the like...
Pluots
and like fucking
plums and apricots. I don't know.
Yeah,
the grape.
Kiwikles.
Don't we have like the grapes now that taste like
cotton candy?
Did we talk about that?
Yes.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Yes, they're insane.
Wait, grapes like fruit? Physical fruit grapes.
Physical fruit grapes. Like it looks like a bunch of grapes, and you pop one in your mouth, and it tastes like fucking cotton candy. It's insane. I bring
bonkers.
Them to parties sometimes because I'm like, it's healthy, but trust me, you're gonna like it. And people don't believe me, and then they eat one, and they're like, oh my god.
Okay, back up.
You can get them at Gelson's. When they're in season.
Okay, but what? How?
I don't know.
Did
just crossbred.
Somebody was just eating grapes, like testing the grapes, and they're like, grape, cotton candy.
No, they.
The fuck is
they're
this?
Like,
cotton candy?
It's specifically a crossbred. Yeah. No, specifically a crossbred breed.
But is it a crossbred breed, or is it bred because somebody was literally like, oh, this one tastes sort of like cotton candy. This one over here tastes sort of like cotton candy. Let's breed these.
Now it really tastes like cotton candy. They were specifically crossbred to taste like cotton candy.
By the way, that is all genetic modification.
Yeah. I wish it'd be great to be able to turn like anything into bacon now, like bacon-flavored grapes. Come
bacon
on.
Bacon-flavored grapes.
You pop one in your mouth, it's an explosion of bacon juice.
I mean, look.
I don't know.
You are right.
What I think about it.
You are right, sir. Right, okay. Because A, bacon... Very fatty.
It's delicious.
Bacon of avocado. An avocado that tastes like bacon.
Oh, that would be good.
Oh, sorry, continue. I was just
thinking, I'm hungry. What if I was just thinking, I'm hungry. I'm actually hungry, too. I need breakfast,
too. We're recording this a little earlier than we normally do.
It's a little early.
A little early.
I mean, it's not like, it's 6:30 a.m.
Yep.
Because that would be a fucking hilarious show.
Oh, my gosh. I would just come over in my pajamas. Maybe we have to do that once.
Yeah.
We should do a slumber party.
Yay!
Yay! Great vibes and good luck!
Slumber party.
Oh, dear.
It's my party. I'm a slumber. I want to.
What?
I don't know. But I love that idea.
Like, we need to have sleeping bags and we all fall asleep on the floor afterwards.
That'd be so great. We should stream it.
Ooh.
We could do a stream, like, we could watch shitty horror movies from the
80s. Oh, my gosh. Okay, and, we're putting these ideas out there, and our fans are going to get really excited, and that it's never going to happen, like the t-shirts.
Never gonna happen.
So, remember
never
when
gonna
I had this great idea of, like, making t-shirts?
We have, like, great designs. People send in stuff.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, we haven't talked about, yeah, we haven't talked about Space Wolves.
Oh, Space Wolves.
The thing that Tom, or
oh,
Tim
Artist wants. Tim. Artist Tim yeah. sends
yeah,
that
he
in.
Sent, yeah, he sent in a
it's pretty
artist
awesome.
Rendering
yeah.
a potential Space Wolf, which was fantastic because
yeah,
I did not.
It's super cool.
Yeah.
I thought Space Wolves were just wolves in space. He,
he
went far and above
further,
yeah.
and made space fucking wolves. Like, I want to hang out with that Space Wolf.
Yeah,
you know what
really
I mean?
Cool.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Space Wolf.
All right, let's get some emails.
Oh my gosh, we haven't even done that.
I know,
that.
I know. Well,
well
it's
we jumped a little. Right. We jumped
yeah, yeah,
a little.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
let's
what?
Do this one.
Ooh,
So this is very interesting. So we talked about passwords.
Yes.
We talked about passwords, how annoying they are.
Yeah.
A lesson in password security / maintenance.
Ooh.
Hello, gang.
Hi.
Pause. Hello, Allison.
Who is it? You didn't tell me their name.
Michael.
Hi, Michael.
Poisner. Pause.
Oh.
Don't worry. Close enough.
Nice.
The guy definitely knows our beats.
No, it's isn't this Mikhail?
It might be Mikhail. I don't know.
No, Mikhail.
Mikhail.
The thing? Isn't this our...
Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Wow.
This is our friend from Poland, I think.
Okay. I like it. All right, here we go.
That
ready?
Up?
Seems like we're back on this topic earlier, the password security. Back in the early days, this came up a couple of times. Ah, memories of one-sentence stories, Allison singing,
jeez.
And
oh,
Alex
boy.
Thinking about a new car, maybe a Tesla.
Oh, it happened. Yeah.
On the topic of password security, yes, a portable safe would be nice, especially if it's off the grid. Of course it would be.
Yeah.
A note with clues is also a good option.
See?
But you can do better. Take it from a professional. Have you tried turning off it off and on again, guy? Number two question, when was the last time you changed your password? Yes, that will have expired. Here are the methods I suggest. Here's a method I suggest.
Okay.
This. At first, I was like, I don't understand this. And then I was like, oh, my God, this might be bloody fucking genius. Okay.
Bloody genius.
One, make a list of 26 words.
Okay.
Each beginning with a letter of the alphabet.
Oh. Like apple,
pick
banana,
names, fruits,
cantaloupe,
whatever. Like oh, fruits, boom. Pro tip, if you can do it in a foreign language, even better.
Oh.
Now, instead of choosing one super duper password, make the link to the account and use the same format. Here's an example. Have you heard of Facebook?
Yes.
Their website is www.facebook.com.
Yeah.
So we start with Felicia, Allison, Chad.
Felicia. Oh, because F-A-C.
Yeah, so the first three letters
okay.
are the letters that you then turn into the 26 words.
Right.
Okay? Huh. AKA the first letters of the page we get from our list. But we can go safer than that. The URL is 14 characters long.
Okay.
So Felicia, Allison, Chad, 14.
Okay.
And capitalize all the letters. So capital F, lowercase.
Capital F, capital A, capital C.
Exactly, 14. Even safer still, it's a .com. So let's say Felicia, Allison, Chad, 14, pound.
Why pound?
Pound is if it's a .com, exclamation point if it's a .org.
I've never heard that before.
No, he's saying that's part of the thing.
Oh,
that's part of your system.
Well, then you have to say that.
No, but he didn't say that. He implied
okay.
it. It was implied.
Okay.
The thing is, you can puzzle or be creative. You just need to figure out your method. Maybe only count the letters in the actual name. Maybe all the letters plus or minus a fixed number. Maybe go with a word, number, word, symbol, word system.
Wow.
There are countless numbers of options. You don't need to remember any passwords.
Yeah, that's
just
true. You just look at the URL.
Is.
Yeah.
Exactly. For this example, Twitter would be Tom Walter Iris 11 hash or pound.
Yeah.
Good luck. No, this is not my method. Heck, I'm an admin. I can always use test 1234. Take care.
Take care.
Come to Belgium. Talk science.
Belgium. There you go.
Belgium.
Not Poland.
Hey, Belgium.
Belgium.
Very cool.
I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah.
I was like, I might actually do that.
Yeah.
Not
I know.
That method, but I might do a thing where I'm like, let's come up with a new password method.
Cool.
Yeah.
Because there are times when I'm like, first off, NVIDIA. I love NVIDIA.
Yeah.
I have a Titan X in my PC, and it's awesome.
Sure.
I don't need a new, like software experience, so they have, like, I just need the driver to work, right?
Right.
they now force you to do this like GeForce experience where it like wants to scan your games and do all this stuff. And I was like, no, it wants you to now start to have friends and they can see when you're online. I'm like, no, none of that.
No.
I just want my driver to work. I went to go get my driver like 3 months back or something like that. And it was like, okay, log into your GeForce Experience account. And
oh,
I was like,
gosh.
I've never made a GeForce Experience account because I don't want one.
Yeah. Right. Yep.
So then I had to set up this whole thing. And of course, I'm like, one and done. I don't give a shit what the password is.
Right.
I'm just going to let me get my driver. Yeah. 3 months later, driver needs to update. Log in. Oh, we can't find your login. So now I have to go through this thing where every 3-4 months I'm forget passwording this system that I don't want to be involved with.
Yeah. Or
it won't let me get the drivers unless maybe there's a way that I can get around it. All
right. Right.
And then also, I think it's Best Buy. I can't remember. There's one thing that I did have to like sign into, but it wants an extra thing. That is not part of my password.
Really?
Like, what do you mean it wants an extra thing?
It's like, oh, you also have to have like a symbol
or
whatever.
Oh, I see.
And,
that
like,
isn't
I'm
part
not
of
using
your regular routine.
In my routine.
Yeah.
So then I put it in because I need to sign in, and then I never remember
right.
that.
Right. No, of course not.
So I am 100% on board with this.
That's a good idea.
And I think I'm going to just spend you know what? It's a lovely Saturday.
That's what
I
you're going to do?
I think I'm going to just spend my
changing
Saturday
all your passwords?
Changing all my passwords.
Wow.
Yeah. And let's see how fucked up I get by the end of the week where I'm just like, I can't get into anything. And you come over. I'm like, it's dark. I haven't shaved or showered. And I'm just like, I can't get my phone
I'm locked
won't work.
Out of everything.
I can't check my emails.
So this might be the very last half hour happy hour.
Yeah.
Because Alex will lock himself out of the computer.
Cowering in my Tesla. I'm like, it's the only thing. I have a key.
Yeah, it doesn't need a password.
Tesla, oh, it doesn't. That's right.
It's just a key. Actually, I'm sure it needs a password.
There's got to be a password for something.
But I like that idea. I'm really like, I'm sort of behind that because I feel like, I feel like I'm done being a slave to my own password.
Yeah.
You know
what I mean? It doesn't feel good.
Man. And then it's like,
screw the
man. You accidentally say it or like you tell somebody because they need it for something. And you're just like, now it's in the world.
Yeah.
Now it's in the world. I'm fucked.
Yep. Yep.
I'm fucked.
Yep.
Because it's in the world.
It's in the world.
God damn it.
Side note, Alex's car is named Bucephalus. So I'm just saying
it could be
your password
Although
somewhere.
That just came out of
Bucephalus.
My butt. Because I found my anus. And I pulled that name out of it. I just knew where it was going to be a couple days from now.
Yeah. I feel like we have to talk.
And I was right.
I feel like we have to talk about that article that came out that was like, scientists want to probe Uranus for gas or something like that. And everyone was like, this is the best headline ever.
Oh, my God.
Brilliant.
Yep.
It's so great. There's some really good. Here's the thing.
What's the thing?
Oh, my God. There are stuff that has started to happen lately. I mean, I know it sort of has always happened, whatever. But there are things that I see that are actual headlines that I'm like, that's an Onion article.
Oh, right? I know.
And it's not an Onion article. Like, did you hear about this whole Bill Cosby thing?
Yeah.
What?
Yes.
So Bill Cosby. So, you know, Bill Cosby was.
He's been under trial.
He's been under trial for sexual assault, for drugging women, having sex with them. I think it was the second mistrial. Was it the second mistrial or something?
I don't remember. But
anyway, it was just mistrial. They couldn't come to an agreement on his charges. So charges are dropped, or not dropped, but they're deciding whether they're going to retry him.
Right.
He is going to be now doing town hall meetings.
What?
Around the country.
What?
Talking about how you can avoid sexual assault.
You can avoid sexual assault or how you can avoid being... charged for, I forget, but it was ridiculous. Yeah, find that headline because
it
says it right there, but it's so wrong.
Yeah. Bill Cosby to host town hall meetings on how to avoid rape charges.
To avoid
he is literally going to go
help.
And I was like,
people,
this cannot.
I know
this cannot be real.
Yeah.
This cannot be real
because it makes it sound like he's trying to dodge rape charges. I think the intent is saying.
Here's how not to rape somebody?
Yeah, like...
Why do you have to have a town hall about them? Don't put your penis in them.
Right.
Boom. Oh,
my gosh.
You have to... If you put your hand on somebody's boob and they're like, please don't, you go, oh, shit, I...
Well,
totally
but
off.
In his case, it's the implication is that those women didn't have the capacity to say no.
100%.
So. Yeah.
But anyway... That's just one of those things where I was like, shit, so like Uranus, gas, all that stuff. It's like, no, that's not a real
thing. That's not a thing.
But then you're like... That's a fucking real thing.
If Bill Cosby's doing this, that's also a real thing. Yeah.
This is, that is like a, that's a full thing. I heard about that yesterday, and I was like, I know things.
Our
but
world is getting weird.
Yeah.
Our world is getting weird.
So we've talked about this, right? Yeah. About the whole concept of the title of that it's Cormac McCarthy book, right? The No Country for Old Men.
Oh, that's
that is
haven't talked about this.
The title of that movie, that whole book, yeah. Like, and movie, if you watch the movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
That whole book and movie is about the fact that as you get older,
right.
The world just seems shittier than it was when you were younger.
Is that what it's about?
Yeah, there is literally no country for old men. And
for Tommy Lee Jones.
Well, yeah, because at the end he goes and talks to that guy who was like, my grandfather was murdered and hung by Indians on this porch. Okay. Like, we couldn't walk out our front door without potentially being shot by arrows by Native Americans because we stole all their land.
Right.
And he was like, it's not any worse now than it was then.
Right.
And it's just that you're old and no old person thinks the world is better than it was when they were a kid.
Yeah. Oh,
even though they had polio.
I feel like there was a peak, though. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like in my, like, late 20s.
Yeah.
Everything seemed pretty fucking good.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
It was definitely better than when I was a kid.
I agree.
Yeah, no.
And then all of a sudden, we've taken this nosedive into.
Yeah, but the theory
is what the hell is happening?
But the theory is that the world hasn't gotten any worse. You are just aging.
Yeah,
and so now you can
seeing it with different eyes.
Well, I think in your 20s, you're probably not really peeling back the onion of life.
Right.
You're just getting drunk
and trying to.
You're just getting drunk trying to put your penis in things, or to find penises to put on top. I don't know.
Penises put on top?
Oh, it's a thing.
It's a thing.
Put on
you
top
haven't
of
seen
what?
Penis
we
ads?
We went to
anyway.
The gay pride parade. We
it's great. It's great. Anyway, but that's the whole concept of No Country for Old Men.
Interesting.
Wow.
Because it's like, you think about it like, oh, if I had a time machine, I'd go back to the Middle Ages.
Ironically.
Like, yeah, where I could get, like, cut my hand on a thing, get an infection, and die.
Yeah.
Just be dead.
Ironically, our entire country is being run by old men right now. I think that's
old
the problem.
White men.
Yeah, that's honestly old rich white men. And by the way, I hope to someday be an old rich white man.
Yeah, right.
I agree.
I am striving for that. I'm not knocking anybody
just
down.
Just not an asshole old rich white man.
Yeah, but I just kind of feel like maybe some women in there.
Yeah.
Maybe like a young person.
Someone pointed out that this like horrific healthcare bill that they're trying to pass actually. The abbreviation for it is BRCA, which is the same abbreviation for the breast cancer gene.
Oh, BRCA.
Yeah, it's
oh
BRCA.
My God.
Wow.
And so someone's like, that's weird. It's almost like there were no women to tell them.
Oh. we're horrible.
Why would you name the healthcare bill
after a breast cancer gene?
Oh, good Lord.
Good times.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm very, I don't know how to explain it. I grew up, my dad, politics, DC, all that shit. So it's like, anytime you grow up and your dad does something, you usually sort of like, nuts to that, right?
Yeah. Right.
So I hate politics. Yeah. And I think it's just, I know it has to exist, sort of.
Right.
I think there's a way better way to do it.
Yeah.
We've found the best shitty way. You know what I mean?
This is true.
Yeah.
We literally have found the best of all the shitty ways that you can govern.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Dictatorship, way worse.
Yeah, totally.
You know,
I guess it can't get worse.
Frickin' oligarchy, whatever. Worse.
Yep.
You know, but
Czars.
Never good.
Fiefdom, is that a
fiefdoms?
Thing?
Fiefdoms.
Yeah, all these things. Up. Yeah, the class system? Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like all that stuff. Surf system,
Surf system.
All that is bad. So we haven't really found a good one yet. We just have the best of all the worst ideas.
Yes.
Gosh.
So I'm hoping at some point somebody goes, but this is the problem. It's like, you know, as my friend says, it's really hard to change the engines on a 747 when it's flying through the air.
Wow. I've never heard that before.
Yeah. That's basically a way to say, like, shit is going that way.
Yeah.
You can't, we couldn't be like, okay, we're going to totally change democracy.
Revamp this.
It's going to be fucking great.
Yeah.
Fuck all the stuff that you think.
Yeah.
You know, the electoral college out the window. We're going to change it to a popular vote.
I mean, it's the reason Rome fell, basically, because there was no way to change what their governments were doing. And
except stabbing people was sort of their way.
Super stabby.
It was like, seriously? That guy
had to get super
that
stabby.
Guy's sewage bill is fucking atrocious. Yeah. I'm going to stab him. I'm going to stab him.
It's
probably the only
works
way.
Pretty well, actually.
Yeah.
I'm saying.
I mean, except
you got to teach
someone
a lesson.
Yeah. It's like, oh, God. Oh, man. Bill, my kidney? Fuck you, man. Look, my people just didn't like your bill.
Yep. Nope.
And so I had to stab. That's why it's called a bill, by the way. It's
why?
Because of the old Roman Senator Bill that was stabbed.
Oh, fucking Bill.
Not many people know that. It's the etymology of the
there
word bill.
We've had so many facts on this episode.
Yeah. It's a very fact-filled episode.
So many facts.
Yeah.
You should take all of them home.
Yeah. Fact. All right. We should probably wrap it up.
We have to do a quick little call to action. Or what are we doing?
Sort of a call to action.
Guys, we're trying to work on something really freaking awesome for Comic-Con. Unfortunately, Comic-Con's not making it very easy.
Yeah, Comic-Con this year is going to be interesting.
Yeah, I don't know how much we have liberty to say with how things are being read at Comic-Con right now, but we're trying
to find a space.
We're trying to find a space.
Yeah.
That's what we're trying to do.
We want to do a show like we always do.
Yes. But we want to do it in in a bar. Or in a bar in a restaurant or something like that.
Or a barn if there's booze.
In a barn, yeah. Basically,
all those barns someplace in downtown
with booze. Yeah, someplace with booze.
We want you guys to be able to come and watch us do a show and drink maybe multiple shows. We don't know.
Yeah.
So if anyone who listens to this podcast has a relationship, some sort of friend.
You're the mayor of San Diego.
You're the mayor of San Diego.
Yeah, yeah.
And you know someone who owns or manages a bar or a restaurant near the convention center?
Mm-hmm.
Shoot us an email.
Yeah. We would like to know if there's a space for us for our little show to come
and
have fun with our peoples.
Yeah, and then come see us in San Diego.
Yeah, yeah. Totes.
Yeah.
We shall see how that goes.
Yeah.
We're working on it, but
we have some things in the works, but we're just kind of putting this out there as we don't know what's out there. Because I feel like I once got a tweet from someone who told me to come visit them at this restaurant that they manage, and I just couldn't find that tweet, so I'm hoping that person is someone who listens to the podcast.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah. I want to say it was a barbecue joint or something in San Diego.
That sounds fun.
Barbecue.
Barbecue.
Yeah.
A Texas place or something.
Ooh, good.
And we also, if you guys have, I have this place, but it was rented out for the evening, we can do it at
during the day. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
We are flexible.
We
are flexible.
There are only two things that I think we can't do, which is Tom... I think, have they said that you're going to be on the...
Yeah, we're doing a panel.
A panel. Okay. I'm hosting
Friday,
a panel. So there's two little windows.
Okay.
Other than that, wide open.
Work. We'll make it
wide
work.
Wide open.
Definitely.
Great. Yeah. Okay, so that's you guys. Help us out.
Yeah. Good on ya.
Please help us.
Good on ya, mice.
Anyway, to email us.
Yes.
To email us suggestions.
Let's say I was somebody who could help.
Yes, you could email us. Or if you just wanted to email us stories and things like that.
Yeah.
Or how to fix your passwords and things like that.
Guys,
you
guys are great.
Yeah.
Honestly, a lot of information this
seriously,
one.
Seriously,
a lot of information.
You can email us at halfhourhappyhourfans@gmail.com. Follow us on Twitter, halfhourhappyhr. Please subscribe to us and rate us on whatever it is you listen to us on, iTunes, Stitcher. Google Play. That's another one we're on.
I love that you literally had the blank look in your face what's a third one? What's a third
one? There's another one. And that is it for this edition of the Half Hour Happy Hour with Allison and Alex. I'm Allison Haisler.
And I'm Alex Albrecht. Sitting in with us, as always, the man of the hour, Tom Super Volcano Krajewski.
Thank you for having me on your show, Allison.
Hey, good work, guys. Hey, by the way.
You're welcome.
It's nice in the morning, isn't
it?
Yeah, we're not sweating our butts off.
All right. Be well, everybody. Do something good.
Now leaving Nerdist.com.